the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages. Amen.
what God will do with my soul and my life in the days that fall nigh. And counting with them that were down to the dead, having promised an hour to have called three among the dead by the bodies of the flesh, that sleep in the grave from the hour of my personal war, and they are cut off in my hand. They lay me in the lowest pit, in the darkness and the shadow of death. Against me is that anger made strong, and all my fellows cast them about upon me. Thou hast removed my friends apart from me, they have made me an abomination within themselves. I have been delivered up, and I have not come forth. My eyes were all beautiful folly. I have cried to thee, O Lord, the whole day long. I have stretched out my hands as to be made from the dead without my corners, or shall resist and raise them up, and they may convince and feed. Nay, shall any of the grave tell of thy mercy, or of thy truth and thy destruction? Nay, shall thy wonders be known in thy darkness, or the righteousness in the land that is forgotten? But as for me unto thee, O Lord, if I cry, and in the morning shall I prayer come before thee. Wherefore, O Lord, dost thou cast off my soul, and turnest thy face away from me? A poor man am I, and in troubles from my youth. Yea, having been exalted, I was humbled and brought to distress. Thy cares have passed upon me, and thy cares have totally troubled me. They came round about me like water all day long, and compassed me about together. Thou shalt remove the bar from me, friend and neighbor, my acquaintances, because of my misery. O Lord, God of my salvation, by day I have cried and by night before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, God, out my hearing and my supplication. Bless the Lord, my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, my soul, and forgive not all the iniquity. Who is gracious unto thy iniquities, who healeth all my infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who filleth thy desire with good things, and my youth shall be renewed as equal. The Lord hath called thee to mercy and executeth judgment for all that are wrong. He hath made his ways known unto Moses, unto the sons of Israel, the things that he hath willed. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long suffering and plenteous in mercy. Not unto the end will he be wrong, nor unto eternity will he be wrong. Not according to our iniquities hath he dealt with us, neither according to our sins hath he rewarded us. For according to a high covenant of heaven from the earth, the Lord hath made his mercy prevail over them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our iniquities from us. Like as the Father hath compassion upon his Son, so hath the Lord hath compassion upon them that fear him. For we know of where we are made, yet he never feared us. As for man, whose days are as the grass, and the flower of the field, so shall he blossom forth. For when the wind is passed over, then it shall be gone, and no longer will it know the place thereof. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity, even unto eternity, upon him that feareth him. And his righteousness is upon the sons and sons of God, and keep his testament, and remembrance of them to do that. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne, and his people will come for all. Bless the Lord, all you, the Savior, whose mighty strength, and perform his word, and hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, all you, his hosts, his ministers, and people of God. Bless the Lord, all you, his works, and every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul. And every place of his dominion, bless the Lord, my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, be hearing my supplication, and my truth, heart, and to bring my righteousness. And enter not into judgment with my spirit, and from my sight shall know that I will be justified. For again, he hath persecuted my soul, he hath held my life after the earth. He has sat in the darkness of self with them all together, my spirit within me has become despondent. Within me, my heart is troubled, I remember the days of old, I have given all my works, I have thought about the creation of thy hands. I have stretched forth my hands unto thee, my soul first to God, who is at the bottom of his hand. Look and hear me, O Lord, my spirit, and flee from my way. Fear not that face away from me, lest the dead men look down into the pit. Cause me to hear thy mercy, O Lord, for in thee I put my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk, for to be a better care of my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, and to be able to pray for refuge. Keep me to do that love for thou, my God, and the Spirit shall live me in the land of righteousness. For thy name's sake, O Lord, thou shalt keep me, and thy righteousness shall bring my soul out of affliction. And in thy mercy shall the ugly destroy my enemies, and thou shalt cut off them that put my soul upon thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. Thy good Spirit shall lead me in the land of all highness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, one and all, and to the days of Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. For our God is not dead, but we live.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls. For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who with faith, reverence, and fear of God enter therein, for our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priest, and the diaconate in Christ, for the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have
Let us praise the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States and also authorities in far-off sources everywhere, especially for Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Judge, Lord, Father, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Adam, and Skyler, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for all seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For troubles by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, for those under persecution, for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, and mercy us, and keep us all God by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Come to remembrance, our holy, immaculate, most blessed, and glorious Saint, for us, and ever Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves to each other and our life unto Christ our God.
Most blessed.
after the brilliance of the angel, they trembled within this astonishment, saying, "Hath it been stolen and rolled from paradise to the heap? Or is he risen up before his passion, this preached resurrection? Verily, Christ God hath risen, granting resurrection and life to those who are in Hades. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Thou hast suffered crucifixion willingly, O Savior, and mortal men placed in the new tomb, he who disestablished the corners of the world with the word. Therefore hath death, the stranger, been bound, and taken captive, being defeated. And all those in Hades cried out to thy reviving resurrection. Verily, Christ, the life giver, is risen, for he is everlastingly constant. Both now and ever, and to ages of ages, amen. The mystery which is hidden from everlasting, and was unknown of the angels of the apostles, was revealed to thee, to those who dwell upon earth, in that God, having become incarnate in unconfused union of his own good will, accepted the cross for our sake, wherein by the raised man first created, and hath saved our souls from death.
Thou hast rise from the tomb, O Christ, Savior our God, because thou art deathless, and thou wast raised with thee in thy glory by thy resurrection, and hast crushed the mind of death, proclaiming resurrection to all. Wherefore we glorify thee, O God, who alone art merciful and the lover of mankind. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Gabriel descended from the sublime height, wrapped in a white robe, and came to the stone where the rock of life was. And he shouted to the weeping woman, saying, "Cease your wailing and crying, and receive ye smiling joy and comfort. For he whom you see weeping is very divisive. Wherefore, go and proclaim to the apostles that the Lord is risen. Hold now never in the ages of ages. Amen. All the ranks of the angels, O thou who art undefiled, have been dazzled by the secret of thy dreadful birth-giving, that the all-encompassing and assigned from him who encompassed in thy bosom and the babe, and that he who is before eternity received his corporeal cooking, and that he who feedeth every living breath with his ineffable goodness was nourished with milk. Wherefore did thy glory today glorify thee with praises, for thou art truly the day of hope."
Let us hear thy power, Lord, teaching thy statutes. The company of the angels was amazed when they beheld thee conquered among the dead. Yet thyself, O Savior, destroyed the power of death, and with thee raising up Adam and releasing all men from hell. Let us hear thy power, Lord, teach me thy statutes.
and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For blessed is thy name, and glorified is thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
That was just because our God granted the road great mercy. The man is suffering to my youth from that, but thou, Savior, assist and save me. O ye haters of thine, depart and change from before the Lord, that you should be jarred by fire as a grass. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and in the great days of Amen. By the Holy Spirit, every spiritual man shall be purified, ascending and going to the one hidden and pure of purity.
To thee, O Lord, have I cried fervently from the depth of my soul, let my divinest. Listen to me, let thy divine ears listen to me. All those who have placed their trust in the Lord shall transcend all sorrows. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Verily, the Holy Spirit doth overflow with streams and passages of grace, and doth water all creation with refreshing life.
Let my heart rise to thee, O Lord, and let not the pleasures of the world enter into me by this earthly life. And as each of us hath surpassing love to his mother, the more we love the Lord with utmost fervor. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and for ages and ages. Amen. By the Holy Spirit cometh the riches of divine knowledge, divine vision, and wisdom. For through him the word is proclaimed all the commandments of the Father.
Arise, O God, all this
him they did not see. he interpreted to them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself. So they drew near to the village to which they were going. Jesus appeared to be going further, but they constrained him, saying, "Stay with us, for it is now toward evening, and the day is far spent." So he went in to stay with them. When he was at table with them, he took the bread, and blessed, and broke it, and gave it to them. And their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, and he vanished out of their sight. They said to each other, "Did not our hearts burn within us while he talked to us on the road, while he opened to us the scriptures?" And they rose at that same hour and returned to Jerusalem. And they found 11 gathered together, those who were with them, and said, "The Lord is risen indeed, and has appeared to Simon." Then they told what had happened on the road, and how he was known to them in the breaking of the bread.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
In the beginning of the resurrection of Christ, let us bow down before the Lord, O Jesus, the only sinless one. Thank God to be the Lord of Christ, and the holy resurrection of the face of our God. But now our God will be no longer before thee. We call upon thy name, O God.
Teachers, Mary's of the great Gregory the theologian and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, Cyril and John, the merciful patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myers, Bernard of Cnidus, and Catharius of Pentapolis, the wonder workers of our fathers of honor, the saints, Tikhon, Pedro of Moscow, and Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the trophy bearer, Demetrius the first beamer, Theodore the soldier, Theodore the general, and me as the wonder worker of the higher marches, Ignatius, the god bearer of Antioch, Paranamos, and Eleutherios of the holy, glorious, great Christian martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Theodox, Bunchy, Marina, Periskeva, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone in the ascetic life of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious, unmercenaries, Cosmas and Damian, martyrs in Rome, new martyr Constantine in Cyprus, and venerable John of Wylo, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, we beseech the almost merciful Lord, mark and answer the petitions of us sinners, who make our supplications unto thee and have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Together.
magnified in song.
My soul is magnified, the Lord is good, the Lord is good. More honorable than the cherubim, and more glorious beyond compare than the seraphim. How without sin, there is God the Lord, and our truly theos, all those he has required thee. For you to write the loveliness of heaven, for the openness of our generation shall call me blessed. More honorable than the cherubim, and more glorious.
Holy is the Lord your God,
Oh, saving life, blazing stars, oh, ever saving one.
Lord,
have mercy.
For
travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Christ our God, trembling down death by
sweetness, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All thy remembrance, our holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious, thank you, dear, help us now to be there. All the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
From the
wondrous. I beheld the Lord ever before me.
Wisdom.
The reading is from St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians.
Let us attend.
Brethren, you are the body of Christ and individually members of it. And God has appointed in the church first apostles, second prophets, third teachers, then workers of miracles, then healers, helpers, administrators, speakers in various kinds of tongues. Are all apostles? Are all the prophets? Are all teachers? Do all work miracles? Do all possess gifts of healing? Do all speak with tongues? Do all interpret? But earnestly desire the higher gifts. And I will show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith, so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends.
Peace be to thee that... Anyway, peace be to thee that readeth. There you go.
Christ does have a body,
we mystically are that body. And as you know, a human body is made up of many members, each with its own unique function, contributing to the life of the whole. And in turn, each member, each organ, each part of the body draws its life from the body. So the body cannot live without the members, and the members cannot live without the body. This was a radical new concept for the Corinthians, not so much the biological aspect, but thinking of themselves in that way, instead of as isolated individuals, but more as members, literally, of one another. This is for the basis of Paul's collectivist moral teaching to the Corinthians, when he said that if any one of you sins, he sins against the whole body. It's not just me, myself, and I. And of course, all of the important instruction and ministry of the church comes from this idea that we are no longer isolated. We are no longer individuals, but we are members. We are persons. We are in communion with one another. To continue the biological metaphor, we might say that ministry is another day for each member performing its normal, healthy function for the good of all. The ministry of the heart is to pump blood. The ministry of the brain is to get us in trouble. You know, Paul spoke of apostles, prophets, teachers, speakers in tongues, and interpreters. These are organs in the body of Christ, ministering in their own unique way. And of course, they included helpers, healers, administrators. Elsewhere, they speak of even those with the gift of hospitality. What a wonderful thing to think. There's a hospitality organ in the body of Christ. Some of you may be that very one. Some of us may not be. But even, I think, how do we exercise our ministry? Even, you know, at the coffee hour, I'm always encouraging, invite somebody over to your table. Maybe we can stop folks from forming cliques and hanging out with the folks that they like, but you can be hospitable and invite someone to your table from time to time. I think that's a good thing. It's, you know, it's welcoming, and it's performing a function so necessary. There are many ways to serve as members of Christ. But the one thing that they all have in common, and the one thing that really gives meaning to them all, the life blood of the members' function, their ministry, is love. Absolutely. Paul was abundantly clear on this. Without love, he wrote, it's all nothing. We are a clanging gong, or was it a clanging cymbal, whatever. We're a lot of noise, and no warmth, no heat, no love. Love is the basis of all ministry within the church, being both the inspiration to serve and the very thing that fills our service with meaning and purpose. Without love, there is no life in the body or any of its members. And this makes sense when we remember that God is love. This is how God operates. Every action of God is an expression of his love. And God simply cannot act in any other way other than in love. God is love. All things were created by him out of love. And when we rejected him, his love hastened to save us at great personal sacrifice, which, by the way, sacrifice is a hallmark of love. That's how you know love, because it often has to give of itself to love the other. Even at the last judgment, God will not lay aside his love at the time when we most need it. We might think, you know, God, if you really love me, be with me at the judgment. Well, be careful what you ask for, because if anything, at that day, his love will shine brighter than at any thousand suns. And the light of God's love will penetrate even the darkest corners of men's souls to reveal what lies inside. If love is found, then there will be great rejoicing. And if love is absent, there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. So there is, you see, even in the judgment, it is a judgment of love. With this idea that God, you know, suddenly drops the love mask and puts on the wrath mask, that's just not true. Maybe it would be easier if we faced the God of wrath, but we face something even more terrifying, a God of love. Terrifying, and we have no love. But, you know, something to rejoice if we have made ourselves to be a reflection of God's love. And this is why God gives us every opportunity in life to nurture and grow love and to become true reflections of His creative and sacrificial love. We generally call these opportunities inconveniences because love always requires sacrifice. And we have to be aware that this situation is not something to avoid, but is in fact God's opportunity to be for me that day to love. Everything you and I do each day, because love is this important. Everything that we do is an opportunity to love God or to reject that love, to move toward Him or move away from Him. And each day we choose between things such as compassion or indifference, between generosity or greed, between gratitude or complaining, just to name a very few. And we may not assign much consequence to these little actions, these little emotions, these little feelings, but they're very important in shifting our heart closer to love or closer to whatever is the opposite of love. Many times we decide to do make decisions on these choices without a thought to love. But I think that's a great mistake. You know, I think about this very thing whenever I'm asked to do something that I don't particularly want to do, which is, you know, like every day. Stella calls me and says, there's this family that you don't know, we've never met, and they live out in East Palmdale, and they want a house blessing. Would you drive out there for a 5-minute house blessing? And we're like, why not? But she knows, right, that I will eventually give in because I'm interrogating myself. It's like, does my impulse lead me to love or away from love? Will I choose to be guided by love and a willingness to enter into the self-sacrifice of Christ? Or merely will I be guided by my own selfish unwillingness to be inconvenienced? So I honestly think about this more and more all the time, especially when Stella calls me. And by this method, I've discovered two things about myself. Number one, I can be a pretty selfish guy. And she knows, because she's watched me start out with one face and then eventually put on the other, you know. And second, that I can choose to deny my selfishness and to fulfill my function within the body of Christ. You know, if you present yourself with the opportunity, if you interrogate yourself, you suddenly realize, I have a choice. I don't just have to give in to my feelings. You know, I don't want to, and that's as far as we take it. We should ask ourselves, maybe would it be better if I did what I don't want to do? To serve somebody else, to love someone else. I might never make the right choices to move toward a love greater than my self-love if I didn't face this interrogation. And what I'm getting at this morning is that the love of God and the love of one another must be the single greatest pursuit of our life, more than money, house, health, anything else. Pursuit of love, because that alone, love, is the one thing that you can actually take with you into the next world. And it is the one thing that will cause you to stand when you are bathed in the love of God, seeking love in you. God has provided so many opportunities for us to grow in love, and they are called sometimes inconveniences. They are called ministry. Corinthians, he immediately segued into the ministry or the service. Some are apostles, some are teachers, whatever. What better way is there for us to love one another than to serve one another in Christ? That's why I also say that everybody in church, every single person, should, and married persons, should be involved in ministry to some degree in the church, or even outside the church. But every ministry involves a certain measure of self-sacrifice on our part. In other words, it stretches us to love, to care more about just our own convenience. And these things are well spent. This time, this effort, this energy, this money, whatever we need to put in to ministry, they're well spent if we invest them in others and not in ourselves. The more reluctant we are to serve, the more we should step up and do it. Love, after all, is not just the work for others to do, but it must be our work as well. We have an average size parish, I guess, everyone's here. And yet, you know, we have a parish council. Like so many parishes, it's hard to find people who are willing to serve on the parish council. By the way, there's all kinds of ministries in the church. Today we collect food for hungry in our area. Did you bring food today? You could have, if you thought about it, if you remembered it. That's something simple to do. But like the parish council is kind of a joke. Sometimes the parish council is made up of maybe Scott and Bruce, and Linda and Richard, and then other times it's made up of Richard and Bruce and Linda and Scott, you know. Because people don't want to serve. A lot of people aren't qualified to serve, and the qualifications are not really great. You just have to financially support the parish at a certain level. I think we even lowered that level down. We lowered the bar. But it makes sense if you're going to serve on the parish council and spend the church's money and that you have to be kicking into the kitty a little bit. But a lot of people are disqualified when they're nominated because they don't give. Okay, there's a ministry that we ought to think about. The ministry of giving. It's not that we don't like our four or six council members, but they're getting a little tired of being elected over and over again. We need to up our game, I think, when it comes to serving one another in the church. We need to, we need to be qualified at least to the level that we can serve on the parish council in terms of our giving, in terms of our faithfulness in attending church. That's not too much to ask, especially since we, like I said, lowered the bar. We need to consider the truth that everyone should be involved in some kind of ministry. It ought to be on our lips and on our minds. What is your ministry? You know, we have the ministry fair every year where we present just some of the opportunities that we present here. You don't have to go outside the church and be missionaries or whatever, but you could. But we have plenty of opportunities to serve here. And some people, I don't know, they're just reluctant. We're busy. We got too much going on. Whatever. I'm too busy for love. I'm just going to boil it down to that. Ministry is love. Are we too busy for love? Are we too busy to grow? Are we too busy to prepare for that time when we won't be busy because there's nothing left but God, and you either love Him or you don't? We need to up our game. We need to be a church full of ministers. Then I can go fishing. To the glory of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
All folks, save us, have mercy upon us. People from God, by thy grace, wisdom.
Set all with guard always by thy life, we may ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. and Joseph and all them brotherly cry. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always now and ever and to ages of ages. President of the United States and all civil authorities and our armed forces everywhere. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God, for the Archpriest Wayne and his family, for the Archpriest John and his family, for Kevin, Colleen and family, for Wanda, for Donald, Harry and Nadina, for Nadia, Angela, Destiny and Anna, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon and remission of their sins. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God departed this life, especially for the Archpriest Peter, for Maria Stephanie, for the Proto-Deacon Gregory, and for Paul, the Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Thank you. to do all things until thou hast brought us back to heaven, and
and has endowed us with that kingdom which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto thee and to thy only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, for all things in which we know and in which we don't know, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. We give thanks unto thee also for this ministry which thou dost not save to receive in our hands, even though there stand beside thee thousands of archangels and ten thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged, many eyes soaring aloft, borne on their pinions, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and singing.
Thank you. Gracious unto me, a sinner, have mercy upon me. God, be gracious unto me, a sinner, have mercy upon me.
let us attend.
Holy things are for the holy.
Thank you. As a reminder, we are only permitted to serve permitted members of the Eastern Orthodox Church who are in good standing. All are welcome to join us after for the blessed bread that is not a sacrament and that is available to all.
With the fear of God and faith and love, draw near.
Thank you.
us thine inheritance.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
wonder through his grace and love towards mankind, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God, and our whole glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all honorable apostles, of our father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God Joachim and Anna, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious unmercenaries, Cosmas and Damian, martyrs in Rome, the new martyr Constantine in Cyprus, and the venerable John of Rela, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and loveth mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
We will now do a memorial service. It's, I think, the sixth year anniversary of the repose of Father Peter Gilquist. And we have several other people, friends and family members that have passed away. So we are doing a memorial for them.
Thank you.
Pray thee, hearken, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for the repose of thy soul from the servants of God, the Archpriest Father Peter, the Proto Deacon Gregory, Maria Stephanie, and Paul, that departed this life, that thou wilt pardon every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
That the Lord God will establish their souls with a just repose, the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, remission of their sins. Let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and our God.
Grant this, O Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, give rest to the soul of thy departed servants, the Archpriest Peter, or the Proto-Deacon Gregory, Maria, Stephanie, and Paul. In a place of brightness, a place of verdure, a place of repose, whence all sickness, sorrow, and sighing have fled away. Pardon every sin which they have committed, whether by word, or deed, or thought, for thou art good and lovest mankind. For there is no man who liveth and sinneth not, and thou only art without sin, and thy righteousness is to all eternity, and thy law is truth. Thou art the resurrection and the life, and the repose of thy departed servants, O Christ our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, together with thy Father, who is everlasting, and thine own holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Blessed their focus to our most holy, save us.
For out of the moon and the cherubim and the elf compared were glory to us and the seraphim. Thou with us, we bearest God the word, and our food in the altar was prepared in thy deed.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God, and our whole glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and
Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.